let us shift our focus a little bit right now over to the building for phase three, because that's the one where really the sky's the limit and you can do anything. You're starting with a big blank slate and you can put whatever you want out there. So let's go ahead and take a look at that, and I'm going to use it as an example to illustrate the concept of, oh, it's what we call design options, because you want to sort of think about some options for different spaces. What I'm doing is I'm just not cropping, and I'm going to shift it over so that phase three space includes that area over there. Because I want to think about some sort of building that can go kind of in here somewhere. Now, this building could have lots of different pieces to it. Some of it's going to be office and classroom space, meeting spaces, things like that. Think about sort of what you want to have happen relative to these spaces. You sort of enter along this axis. So whatever you do is pretty prominent here. It's definitely going to be the focal point of the journey. Okay. So we can start just by creating some walls. Oh, I'll choose some types. If I want to stick with something that looks very similar, I can use those stone veneer panels. And then I can go through and, oh, maybe at some level there'll be something that looks like this. Okay. But that would be kind of uninteresting all by itself. It's going to have some offices. Oh, who knows? Maybe this one even has, oh, let me kind of pop back out here. You back over there. Give it a little more shape. Trim that up. I'm going to show you this. This is kind of good. I'll just, oops, escape out of there. Let me just grab those surfaces right there and just drag them over. Maybe that one comes back there. Oops. Pull you out over there. I got something going on over here. Again, we haven't really designed anything, so it's all just an example right now. For all those things, let's see how tall they're going up. I want them to actually go up to the roof level. I want them to be all three floors. Okay. Now, in addition to this big building that we're putting over there, we want to have something that's an auditorium, something that's maybe a little bit special. You can make it inside the building, or you can sort of make some external part that's connected to the main building. That's very common. And you want to think about really how you might create that auditorium, what shape it might have, what materials it might have, and you want to come up with two alternatives for what that would look like. Okay, so let's talk about alternatives and how we approach that. Design options and alternatives work in this way. What you do is you plan out a hierarchy of option sets and then options within the sets. Okay, and this is where we start getting to parallel universes. Okay. The main model is what we've been working on so far. That is the one that's the primary universe that everyone lives in. Option set one and option set two are different groups of options that belong together. So for example, if in our assignment we were asked to go through and create sort of some options for the auditorium, and as a second set we were asked to create some options for the student center, so that might be the option set names, and then within those option sets, there's the specific options you're going to illustrate as the alternatives. So let's show you what that looks like. Over here, let me come out and I'll just put some very sort of basic thing. Oh, I'll go through and create a little round auditorium out here. Okay, and I will go ahead and bring those up to the roof level also, or maybe just up to level two. It actually does. I hadn't thought about that. But you're correct. It actually does. That would be the student center in the middle of it. Okay, so we have some sort of, maybe this is my main option, okay, that I want to look at right now. Okay, this is the area right here, okay, where the circle is, where we want to think about sort of different alternatives that can go there. So what we're going to do is as follows. We're going to go up to Manage, and in Manage you'll find something called Design Options. And if you click on Design Options, you get the ability to go through and build the hierarchy. It starts with option sets, and then it's options within each set. So how that looks is as follows. We'll create an option set. I always, once I create these, I rename them, because if I don't rename them, I get confused. Option set one, option one, just gets very confusing to me very quickly. So I'm going to call it the auditorium options. Okay. And within that, we're going to create some different options in that set. Maybe the first one is, again, I'll do a rename. It's going to be the round auditorium. Okay. Maybe for the second one, I'll rename that as something like, oh, that'll be the square auditorium. And maybe for the last one, this will be the round with all kind of alternate seating. So that's one option set and options within them. Okay, let me go ahead and create a new option set. Again, I'll choose that and rename it. That's going to be, oh, my student center options. Then within there, I will go ahead and create one. What'll this one be? This will be cafe area. And then for the new option down there, I'll rename that. This will be one that it's all designed around sort of small group meetings. Okay. But your goal is to really, for the assignment, to come up with two design options and two options within each of those. Okay, we'll go ahead and close that. Okay, so we can go through, set up your hierarchy. Okay, go through and now create the new option sets and the options within each set. And then within these design options, we can go through and either name them, delete them, or accept them as within the option sets. Rename them, new, delete, or accept as primary. Let's talk about what that is. Well, actually, let me do the other one first and then come back to it. This one. Within the design options, I can new, duplicate, I can make one primary. Let's talk about what primary means. The idea is that in any option set, there's one option that's really, it's the leading candidate right now. It's the one that we should show. The other ones are still hanging around as options, but really it's the one that is probably the one we will select. At least we're thinking we'll select at this point. Okay, it's the leading contender. It's automatically displayed in the main model. So the main model has to show something, and by default it'll show the leading candidate. Okay. So we make one of these primary. It's always designated by that little tag that says it's primary. As we go through and we work on our design and we come up with our different options, eventually we'll get to the point where, you know, we decided that's the one. That's the one we're going to go with. Okay. And to do that, that's where we finally say that within this option set, we say we can accept the primary. What that'll do is it'll grab square shape because it's primary, and it'll really promote it to being in the main universe. Okay, it is promoted, the other option sets are deleted at that point. Okay, and the reason we do that is as we keep on working through the project, we eventually need to sort of prune down the tree a little bit. It gets a little bit hairy if all of these different option sets are in there. So pruning just brings it all down. You're just eliminating things. So if I said, for example, make the square shape primary right now, round shape and round with alternate seating would just be deleted from the project because I'm not going to consider them anymore. Okay, so there's making something the primary, that's making it the leading candidate, and then accepting the primary within the option set, that's actually saying, okay, we've made our decision. We're not thinking about the options anymore.
Can you still get it with Control-Z and undoing?
You could still do it that way. Or the best way to do this is, it's actually a very good practice for you now to start saving as every time you open the project. Okay, save as, and I always save as the date followed by some sort of name. That way I can always get back to what I worked on yesterday, and I get back to what I worked on the day before. And now as these projects get bigger and you're sharing with people, the stakes are higher, and our disk space is cheaper than your time. So go ahead and fill up our disk space and be safe about it by saving as. Okay, that's okay. So let me show you how to use these design options real quickly so you just get a real nice sense of how this would work. Okay, before you leave for today. Okay, so I got this round space here. Let me go through and put a couple walls in there. Okay, this is all still in the main design right now. Let me go through and change some things. What I'm going to do is actually grab all of those walls right there and say, you know, those walls are the ones I'm going to put into play right now. Those are the ones that might get changed between the different options. So what I can do is as follows. I'll go to Manage, and I will say Add them to a set. Okay. Putting them in play just lets us copy issues or versions of those walls into each of those sets. I'm going to look at the auditorium options. And for right now, I'm going to copy those into all three options. What that's going to do is actually make copies, physical copies of those in all three of the alternate universes that I can change independently. Okay? So copying into all is usually probably a pretty good starting point. Okay? Right now, I'm looking at the main model. About the only thing that's changed in the main model is I can still select these objects because they're in the main model. But these objects over here, I can't select them right now because they're actually in an option set. So I have to open that option set for editing in order to change them. Okay, so let me kind of show what we need to do. I can go over to the Manage, and in Design Options, I can choose to edit the round auditorium. And if I choose to edit the round auditorium, I can start to make some changes. I can take out some walls. I can go ahead and reconfigure that there. I can go through and take part of the wall. I could split it if I want to, or go through and make it a curtain wall system. But I can make whatever changes I want to make to that. And as I'm making my changes, you'll see that they're actually occurring in all the different views. Okay, so there's my auditorium the way I'm looking at it right now in option one right now. Okay, let's go ahead and switch over to option two. In option two, okay, what I'm going to be looking at is this is the original. This is where we started with when we copied them into the option set. This is the duplicate copy that's over here. So for this one, I can take out some things if I want to. Let me go to the phase three. What am I looking at? I'm trying to click and not getting anything. That should work out okay. Let me go back to level one, phase three. There we go. For this project, for this option, maybe I want to consider sort of a completely different shape. So I will make whatever changes I want to make in this option. Notice when I'm working in the option, the base is grayed out. So this is my squarish option. Okay, again, I go to 3D. Oops. Let me bring those up to the roof the same way. The important thing for you to know is that we're actually working on just alternate versions. Okay, so any changes I make to one won't necessarily affect the others. So again, I come over here, I can look at the round. I can come over here, I can look at the square. Okay, and in the same sense, I could keep on going and making changes to the third one too. That one I wanted to be round also. Again, it starts the same way, but I would change something about the seating. I won't have time to do it today, but let me just kind of rush through that so you can sort of see. So basically, I've created these three different versions of that one part of the project. Okay, finally now, how do you control what you're looking at? Okay, as you're looking, okay, in each of these different views, notice what I'm doing is pulling here and going either to the main model, to round one, to square, around with alternate. Okay. In the main model, what's happening is the one, the primary one is always showing because that's the one, it has to show something, so it's going to show the leading candidate right now. Okay, and we can go ahead and just look at things that way. If I wanted to go through and change the leading candidate, I can say, no, the square one's going to be the leading candidate now. And then by default, it would be shown instead. Now, this whole thing about the views and having the views dynamically change is good as you're doing your design, but sometimes you don't want to have that to happen. Sometimes you'd actually like to have a plan that shows option one versus option two versus option three. And to do that, if you want to lock a view to a specific option, okay, here's what we need to do. So here's lane one, phase three. Okay, that's the default view right now. It's going to always show everything automatically. If I duplicate that view, rename, I'll call this auditorium round. Okay. And if I would like to display that in this view, what I need to do is go to the view properties. It's a visibility graphic, and in the same sense that we've turned on and turned off different things, we now have something for controlling the design options. So rather than automatically displaying whatever's primary, I can choose a specific one to show in this view. So I can have this view show my round auditorium if I wanted to duplicate that. I can have it show my square auditorium instead. Rename it. Make it square, and then finally visibility graphics. I will change the design options. Instead of showing the automatic, I'll choose the square one. Okay, so it's always just a choice. You have the choice of either sort of always showing the primary one, that's the leading candidate, but if you really want to create plans that illustrate the two different options, you can set those views. And that'll work for 3D views too. So for example, if you want to have a 3D view and render it of option one versus a 3D rendered view of option two, you duplicate these different views, then set the visibility graphics to show the right option each of those, and that way you can sort of lock into the alternate version that you want to see in that view. That's a little confusing to get going with. Why don't we break for today, and we'll resume here next time. But if you want to, between now and then, it'd be great to go through, and even before you do all the detailed design work, start just setting up the project with the different levels, or the levels are already in there, with views you need for the different phases, and even give yourself some stubs for the design options. So that, see if you can work with those views and visibility graphics to always be showing something in there, even if it's not your final design. Just something to work with, because it'll organize your work and make it easier to go with next time. Okay? So let's break for today.